Okay, this is the first exercise in Hanon's The Virtuoso Pianist in 60 Exercises. It's the first, and it's also the most basic, but also the most useful, I think. Okay, so the purpose of this exercise is to practice stretching between the fifth and the fourth finger, okay? This happens in both hands. In the ascending, that is going up, this happens in the left hand. In the descending, that's going down, this happens in the right hand. Okay, and we'll go into that in just a moment. The first thing I'm going to do is demonstrate in this neighborhood of the piano. Okay, this isn't where you start, just for demonstration purposes, this will be easier. I'll do it with the right hand first. What we do is we play C, E, F, G, A, okay? And then we play down. Now you'll notice I skipped over the D. I didn't play the D. That allows us to climb higher and higher and higher on the piano. Because I skipped over it, when I come back down, my hand is naturally going to land on the note that I skipped. Then I just repeat the pattern. Okay, and so on. We play exactly the same notes in the left hand, but we use different fingering, of course. And just to recap, we're practicing stretching between the fifth and the fourth finger. So we play. Okay, so. Of course, we don't start here in this neighborhood of the piano. We're actually down here. So now I'm going to play the exercise. I'm going to play half of the first page just so you can see it, just kind of in a slow tempo. And that's the first half of the first page. If we were to do the whole first page, the whole ascending, we would end up here in this area, okay? Now, the two things that tend to get students with these exercises are, one, the transition from ascending to descending, right? And two is the ending. So we're gonna look at just that. In almost all of the Hanon exercises, the transition from ascending to descending happens on these Bs right here, okay? At least in like the first 35 exercises, this is how it goes, for the most part, not every single one, obviously. Okay, in the first exercise, in exercise number one, we play. When we get to the D here, this D, we do not go down to C, right? Like you might think we would do. We go directly from D up to the G here, and then we start the descending. Okay, and then we go all the way down. Let me show you what that looks like without talking. And if you have your Hanon book, you can take a look at that last note of the ascending, and you can see that it is that D right there. Okay, or those Ds, I should say. And now let's hop over to the ending. The ending in this one starts on these Gs down here. Okay, this is the second to the last measure. We play. And then we go straight to the C's. Okay, Now, we're going to use fingers 5 and 1 on those Cs, and the reason why is I'll show you in the next exercise. But just for right now, get into the habit of doing that, okay? Watch that one more time. And tuck a little bit to get on the Cs, okay? All right, so now let's look at that transition, and I'm going to start the transition a little bit ahead of time, meaning I'm going to start a few measures back from the Bs here. I'm going to start on the Gs here. Okay, so I'll play the pattern on G, A, B, and then on B, I'll do the transition going into the descending. All right, watch that. On the ending. Okay. And that is Hanon exercise number 1. Make sure to practice this every day. Don't worry about being super fast. That's not what our goal is at this point. Our goal is just to get the fingers comfortable doing what they need to do. Speed can always be accomplished later once your hands know what they're doing. Okay? All the best. We'll see you next time.